Hello everyone, this is Chinne Dorita Rosa of Vines by Rosa, powered by Highbrow Living Magazine. We are here today at Chateau de la Ligne to give you an inside look at the perfect destination wedding paradise in Bordeaux with a special authentic French welcome by Simone and the famous Irish flair of celebration with Barry and Lisa. Stay with us.
Il y a tout au long des châteaux de la ligne tant de mets si goûteux, trop bons et trop jolis, qu'au milieu des melons, piments et céleri. Il y a de temps en temps quelques garçons qui dansent.
Here we are, still at Château de la Ligne, and I'm going to introduce you to my lovely friend, Lisa. We have a spread right here for you, and I would like Lisa to tell me what exactly we'll be having for lunch today.
Okay, so this is a typical Irish brunch.
Nice.
With Irish sausage, mushroom, fried egg, potato bread, and grilled tomato. And it pairs perfectly for brunch with our crémant de la ligne. And also the peppered snails.
See?
From Africa.
See? My girl's got it. Exactly. We have peppered snails. And I mean real African snails, people. We have it here in Bordeaux. And this goes very well with anything that sparkles. And the Château de la Ligne Crémant is perfect for this. And what next, Lisa?
So this is also a common Irish lunch or dinner. It's honey glazed gammon with fried cabbage and champ, which is mashed potato with scallions.
Oh, that's super. That's going to be amazing. And that
delicious.
Goes very well with your...
Yes, with our
Grand
Reserve.
The Grand Reserve. This is a chateau that has everything. It offers you everything. And as you can see, we have the white wine here, which goes very well with fried rice, right? And then we have, to add to this, we have peppered chicken wings. That would be just amazing with the fried rice. And to sweeten our tooth a little bit, you know, with the rosé, we're going to be having some banana puff puff. People, I am looking forward to this. This is a wedding lunch for you. So wherever you're from, this is something that you would be expecting when you come to Château de la Ligne. The wines and the food are ready to make people happy, right? So stay with us. We'll be there at the lunch table and you'll see us chomping away.
It dates all the way back to 1147. Eleanor of Aquitaine was the very famous historical figure who gave permission for the chateau to be built on this very site. It was originally constructed as a monastery for monks who were on the trail of the Camino all the way to Compostela, Santiago in Spain. And it's well known that the chateau produced wine for centuries and centuries. Unfortunately, 1956 was a very severe winter. The vineyards of La Ligne didn't survive. The owners at the time decided not to replant. So for upwards of 50 years, there was no wine production here at the chateau for the first time in centuries. So my father-in-law, Terry Cross, he visited the place in early 2000, fell in love with the beautiful property here at La Ligne, and he purchased the place, ironically, on St. Patrick's Day 2000. He then had the vision to replant the vines of La Ligne, which he did in 2001 and 2002. And we once again became a wine-producing chateau.
Go! Cheers! Cheers! Cheers. Thank you.